Hello, I'm Rhys Jones, and welcome to this sleep talk down and lucid dream incubation recording. Today, I'll be guiding you through the process of relaxing your mind, preparing yourself for sleep, and then, once your mind space has been softened, sowing the seeds for a lucid dream later on in the night. In this particular recording, the sleep talk down theme will be a sense observation meditation. And the lucid dream incubation theme will be a hike on a starry night. Please note, you're free to fall asleep at any part of this recording, so when you begin to feel tired, don't hesitate to follow that feeling. If that happens during the meditation, that's fine. If it doesn't happen until the starry night hike, that's also fine. First and foremost, prioritize falling asleep. Do not wait for my permission to do so. Follow my words until you begin to feel drowsy, at which point, allow yourself to let go and gently drift away. And so, to begin, please turn off all of your lights. Lay down on your bed and get into a position that you feel comfortable with. Be it on your belly, on your side, or on your back. Whichever position you feel most comfortable in, adopt it now. And then, make any final adjustments you need in order to feel fully settled. For example, perhaps you have an itch. If so, now would be a good time to itch it. Or maybe you'd like to apply some lip balm before snuggling into your comforter nice and tight. Whatever makes you feel at ease is fine and should be done now. If you haven't already, you should now close your eyes and take a deep breath in and out, and another deep breath in and out. Then allow your breath to settle into a normal rhythm, not forcing it to go one way or another. Now, let's just lie here and soak in what there is to soak in. No expectations, no pressure, just quiet observation. Allow yourself to experience the present moment as it is. Feel the fabric of the sheets beneath you, the support of the bed. Hear the sound of my voice. For now, this is where you'll hang your attention, on pure sensation, your raw sensory experience. Curious about these sensations. Don't be numb to them. Instead, inquire, probe, feel every last detail. If you find it easier to home in on one specific sensation, then do that. Or if you're more inclined to take in the entire field, then do that. Remember, there aren't any expectations here. We're simply redirecting our attention away from the hustle and bustle of the mind and towards the stability and consistency of sensations instead. There is peace to be found here, in the focusing of the mind. At first, it might seem dull or boring to focus so acutely on sensation alone, You might even have thoughts like, why am I doing this? Or when is this going to end? But as time goes on, you'll start to settle into the simplicity of it, the predictability of it. Here we're on solid ground, you see, just observing what arises, without clinging or grasping. Here, there is peace. If my voice catches you lost in thought, that's okay. Just softly bring your attention back to your senses. The feeling of your tongue in your mouth. The air going in and out of your nose. The darkness behind your closed eyes. Or perhaps it's not darkness at all. Perhaps hypnagogia is beginning to kick in. If so, observe that too. You are now in a supremely relaxed state, either sleeping or on the edge of sleeping, and so we're ready to begin incubating a lucid dream for later on in the night. By following along with my words and visualizing them as you go, you'll prime yourself to draw upon these very same images during REM. There's no need to follow along strictly. Just continue relaxing and allow my words to wash over you. Whatever images come, come. And even if you're now asleep, know that your subconscious will soak these words in and store them for later. So, let's now begin our starry night hike. You come to in a dark field, peaceful and serene. The temperature is mild and the breeze is soothing. You're standing up, eyes engaged with the night sky. What looks back at you is a sea of stars, as far as the eyes can see, from east to west, shimmering and vibrant. It's a beautiful sight that leaves you awestruck and tingling. And so, you set forth to explore this field. At first glance, it looks like there's not much to explore, just rolling green hills, an open expanse. But you know better than to be fooled by outward appearances. After all, the simplest of things can offer the most expansive of pleasures. So, with a bounce in your step, you head off, excited to see what you'll find. After some exploring, you come across your first oddity. A small hole in the ground. A strange, vortex-like hole that appears to be glitching in and out of reality.
"What's that?"
you say out loud, as you kneel down to get a closer look. It's swirling and glittery and big and small all at the same time. Your mind feels warped by it.
"I don't understand what I'm seeing,"
you think, as curiosity about where you are and what you're doing begins to creep in. Lucidity gently knocking at your door. You find yourself lost in strange thoughts. Thoughts of other worlds, of other times. For a while, you follow these thoughts. Down, down, down the rabbit hole. But then, just like that, a strong desire to reality check kicks in. Probe further.
"What's my name and my address and my age?"
All of these questions hang dryly in the air, unanswered, your mind hitting a wall.
"If I can't recall my personal details," you think, "then surely I'm dreaming."
You lift up your hand and count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 fingers. And any remaining doubt is dissolved.
Thank you.
Now lucid, you look up at the sky again. It looks different this time. Not that it wasn't beautiful before, but through these awakened eyes, these lucid eyes, it's somehow more beautiful, more vibrant, more alive. There are purples and blues and blacks all dancing together, swirling through the great beyond. You feel your heart flutter and your mind race. The thrill of lucidity is with you. In response, before this feeling spirals out of control, you take a few long, deep breaths and rub your hands together to stabilize the scene. The scene is now stable, and your emotions have been effectively modulated. Now you simply walk through the field, observing all there is to observe, enjoying it, but calmly enjoying it. The colors, the smells, the sounds. The scene is awash with stimulus. And now there are butterflies too, fluttering all around you, brushing past your skin. You're in love with this lucid dream, you think. And in some strange way, it feels as if the dream is in love with you too. You have now successfully planted the seeds for a lucid dream later on in the night, and have primed yourself to recognize it as such when it occurs. You're now also in a state of supreme relaxation, fully at ease. Either sleeping or just now ready to begin the first phase of sleeping. And so, with that, I draw this session to a close. Remember, you are a lucid dreamer. Happy dreaming.